Hey guys, it's Aaron, and today we're going to model a business card holder. So I can already hear the comments. I already have a business card holder. I don't use paper business cards. That's too simple. The goal here is to give some good instructions on something that has to be modeled with some precision. And we'll actually talk about how to avoid exact precision because there's some spots where we want a little bit of slop. The idea here is not necessarily to get to the end result, but to practice modeling. So if you're an experienced modeler who wants to kind of just keep on top of your game, and this is something different from what you normally model, it's a good practice to keep, you know, just keep going, keep learning with modeling. If you're a brand new user, then this is a perfect thing. This is a simple, I don't know how long this video will be, 10, 15 minutes at most, that will walk through every single step. So let's do it. Let's hop in. Let's make this thing. All right. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a business card. So I'm just going to come in here and zoom down on the ground. So I'll keep a foot. Okay. So business card's about that big. I'm going to draw a business card. So business card is 3.5 inches. So 3.5 by 2 inches, two. And it's that rectangle. So I'm just going to go like that. So yes, I could have used the rectangle tool, and no, I did not. All right. So this is a business card. Obviously a real business card has some thickness. I'm not interested in the thickness of a card. I'm interested in the thickness of a stack of cards. So I want to have, you know, some space to put a handful of business cards in here. So let's go ahead and pull this up. Like, what's that? Like, yeah, 3/8 of an inch. Let's go 3/8 of an inch. All right. And I'm going to grab that and make it a group. All right, so what I want right now, I'm gonna use rotate real quick just to bring this up right. What I want is a thing that's gonna hold this. Now, I'm almost ready to start building, but there's a couple things I wanna do. One is if my business card holder, if the holder is exactly 3.5 inches, these could be pretty snug, especially if I do 3D print it. And sometimes 3D printing material swells a little bit as you print it because it heats up and cools down, that kind of stuff. So that might be a little bit tight. So I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna give it not a lot, but let's say like 1/8 inch extra on the edge. That's gonna just let me, you know, have a little bit of extra space so there's room for it, but not so much that my cards are gonna slide around and I'm gonna see them, you know, all over the place. The other thing I wanna do is I wanna take this and I want to lean them back slightly. I don't want them just facing straight up. So I'm gonna say like 20 degrees. So what I've created now is basically the negative space I want to maintain when I create this business card holder. So when I make this thing, I don't want it to intrude on any of this space. So this means I can do a couple things. One thing I could do is I could just model I could come in here and just go, okay, here is this, and we'll go like this. And then I could use solid tools to just carve that out and it could be done. That's an option. I'm gonna go a little bit further than that. We're gonna actually create something that's somewhat aesthetically pleasing. So we're gonna do that by tracing around this. So again, we're intentionally a little large this way. We are kind of an arbitrary amount this way at 3/8 of an inch. It's, you know, how many cards is that? I don't even know. And then we're exactly the height of a business card here. So as we make our business card holder, we can decide, is it gonna go past the card? Is it gonna stay low? We can make that decision as we go. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna trace across the bottom with an edge. I'm gonna come up here, let's see, like 1/2 inch. Yeah, that sounds good. 1/2 inch, enter. And then I'm gonna come straight out this way. I'm gonna come out, I wanna have some thickness on this. Let's say, you know what, actually let's do it this way. This will be kind of cool, this will look nice. I'm gonna come out perpendicular to that by hovering over this edge and coming out to where 90 degrees is. It'll snap to pink. And I'm gonna come out this way like, let's say 1/4 inch. See how that looks? No, that's too far out. I wanna cut that in half. So I'm gonna go reference the middle. That's gonna be 1/8 of an inch. And I'm gonna drag that down. I'm just gonna go along like this. All right, cool. I'm gonna come here. This is the lowest point of the cards. I want that to drop down. I like this 1/8 inch. When I 3D print stuff, an 1/8 inch wall is a pretty decent thickness. It's heavy duty enough that it's not gonna, you know, warp or break easy, but it's not so big I'm wasting filament. So I'm gonna stick with that 1/8 inch dimension for my thickness. So I'm gonna come here, I'm gonna drop this down 1/8 inch, I'm going to run this over like that. All right, so let's grab all of that and that, and we'll bring that up. It's underground, that's why it's a little bit gray on the bottom there. All right, so there we go. So now looking at it from the side, this is what the bottom of my holder is going to look like. So let's come up here. I'm just going to draw a line like that. I'm going to go this way, same thing, 1/8 inch. I'm going to run that down like that. I run lines long all the time rather than trying to meet up like this. The problem with just trying to kind of meet up and make sure, well, this is snapping perfectly, beautifully, no problem at all. But if I have multiple points in here or I'm real close to like other geometry, I can sometimes grab the wrong one if I'm out too far. So if I know I want to come along the green axis, I'll just run long like this and real quick turn on erase and just erase those two pieces. So your call though, you don't have to do what I do. You be you, you do your thing. All right, so there we go. That looks pretty good. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this geometry, we're going to run it along like that to hold the business card. But I think, okay, I just did that, so I'm not going to think about it anymore. I'm going to take this and bring it down like 1/4 inch. 1/4, enter. All right, so there we go. So now when I do get down to that last card, it's going to be real easy to grab it. I have a little bit of room for my finger to slip over and grab it. That looks cool. Okay, something I don't like so much. Obviously, I need a lip here to hold the bottom, but I'm covering up a good portion of what would be on my business card with this lip. So I do a couple things. One is I could bring it down lower, which is okay. Problem with that is then it's more likely that the cards will fall out. So what I'm gonna do instead is I'm gonna do something like this. I'm gonna go to the middle. I'm gonna drop all the way down. I'm gonna go inference this point right here, and I'm gonna come over this way 1 inch, bring it up like that. Yeah, I'm going to take that option, copy it over to here. That looks good. And then I'll just push this back like that. Get rid of that. There. So now I can actually see what's in there. I'm going to go a little further. I like that. I like that look, but I'm going to get some more space. I'm going to grab this corner. I'm going to drag it over this way 1/2 inch. And this one this way 1/2 inch. Yeah, see there. So now my cards are in there nice and secure. They're held in. I know I don't have anything on the end yet. That's still coming. They're in there nice and secure, and I can still see the bulk of what's on my card. I'm covering up a little bit in the corners, but most of what I want to show, my logo or my information, still going to be visible in here. So let's keep going. Let's get the ends on here. So this right now, this is all loose geometry, and this is a group. So I can kind of work with this a little bit. I can just take that over like that. And then I'm going to take this out again, that 1/8 inch that I'm trying to use for my material. And then I can also grab this, pull this out like that. And then if I erase these edges, that all goes together. So now it's holding that in there. If I want to check inside here, I can always temporarily hide this piece. Just make sure everything looks good there. Yep. All right. I'm going to Control Z to undo that and then do the same thing over here. Just a quick edge across perpendicular to that, pull it out 1/8 inch. Pull this out to the same amount and then erase those extra edges. Good. That looks pretty cool. Now, it's possible, but it's unlikely that it's going to stay standing upright with this little tiny foot right here. So let's get some more support. I'm just going to come back like this. I'm going to go out to where it's something like that. And then we'll pull that through. I could type in 1/8 inch again, or I could just come hover right here and then erase that. I'll have a line down here, erase that. That's going to give it enough of a leg to stand on. No, I would say no pun intended, but I totally said that as a pun. So yeah, take that how you like. I'm going to bring this over 1/8 inch too. Boom, boom. And there we go. All right, let me take this and hide this again. That looks pretty good. That looks solid. It's not solid. It's actually wide open. So I could come in here and I could close up this right here. So it's one big solid piece. Downside of that, of course, that's a lot of extra material to print. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to keep it open like this. And I think that this 20 degrees is a shallow enough angle that most 3D printers could print that without any support. Same thing here, because I'm coming up, I'm coming up here at 20 degrees. I think all of this could be printed with no support. So I could actually sit this right flat on the print bed, print it in place as one piece, no supports or anything, and have a finished business card holder in, I don't know, maybe a couple hours of printing, something like that, hour and a half. I'm going to triple click and make it a group. And if I do want to make sure this is actually 3D printable, I would want to come up here and go to empty info and make sure it says solid group. It currently doesn't. So in SketchUp for web or with the extension solid inspector, I can always come in here and I can check and see what the problem is. And it's telling me that I do have a stray edge somewhere in here. I could hit fix all, or I could turn on X-ray and I could see where it is. And you can see it's right there. So if I turn this off, see, I got that extra edge just floating in there and I can erase that. All right, with that, now we have a solid group. Perfect. We could take that then if I wanted a 3D print. We've done this in other videos. This is not the point of the video, but we could take that, export as an STL, take it in the slicer, print it out, and have this sitting on my desktop ready to hand out my cards, like I said, in an hour and a half or so. If you wanted, you could take this further. I could put some 3D text right here. I just have to make sure I merge it into the geometry. If I wanted to take this longer, I could take this up higher than the business card and put a logo up there, something like that. But there you go. Pretty simple, pretty easy, basic modeling tutorial, but you get what you, yeah, I mean, not bad for 10 minutes, huh? 10 minutes, half an hour or an hour and a half on the printer, and you got your own custom made, one of a kind business card holder. Well, one of a kind, except for other people who follow along with this and have one, including myself. But yeah, there you go. Again, a fun little quick modeling practice thing. I do think that if you're going to get good at SketchUp, the best way to do that is really to just get in there and use it. Stuff like this, if you can spend a couple minutes modeling something that has some real world dimensions to it, it's fun to do just fantasy models, right? Just model a castle or whatever. That's a great time. But sometimes a little bit of precision is a good way to get good at, you know, precision modeling. Makes sense, right? But this in particular, like I said, we had very specific dimensions, but at the same time, we want to give ourselves a little bit of space so things work together. We got to be conscious of how thick the walls of things are, that kind of thing. So yeah, try it out. Let me know what you think of this. Do you like this kind of modeling practice? This is a fun way to spend 10 minutes. Tell us what you think about this, because we're always playing with our video types, making sure you guys get what you want to see, what you want to watch. And we know that most by hearing from you. If you like that video, click like down below. And if you haven't already, please do subscribe. We create several videos each and every week, and you'll be notified of all of them if you subscribe. Most importantly, though, like I said, leave us a comment. Let me know what you think of this. If you think there's some other model that would make a good video like this, or if there's a whole nother topic or type of video you think we should make that we haven't yet, let us know about that down there too. We like making these videos a lot, but we like them even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.